Namaskar. This video is on a short trip to Dimapur and Kohima in Nagaland. For Dimapur, I had my friend Ajutosh Paul alias Asu with me, while for Kohima, I was alone. We started from Kolkata on the January 14, 2018 and spending a night in Guwahati reached Dimapur on the January 16. Through the photographs and video clips included in this video, I have endeavored to give a presentation of what I saw, where and how. I have included description of places here in my introduction to give a background of these places of importance. Most of these information are available on the internet, but I believe audio-visual version will be more useful. The introduction has been split up in two parts. This first part will be only on Dimapur. Dimapur is the largest city in Nagaland. In the Middle Ages it was the capital of Dimasa Kachhari Kingdom. The name Dimapur is derived from Dimasa language. Di means water, ma means per means city, translating to big river city, associating with the meaning of Kachhari, which is people of the river valley after the river Dansirai which flows through it. Source, Wikipedia. One of the important things to visit in Dimapur is the ruins of Dimasa Kachhari Kingdom, preserved as a national heritage site. It is within the limits of the city. Besides ruins of Kachhari regime, we visited Green Park maintained by Horticulture Department of the Government of Nagaland. The park has a beautiful lake apart from a mushroom development center and an orchard where different fruit trees like mango, orange, cashew nuts etc. are planted and nursed. We visited a crafts village named Dizafi and a household engaged in wood crafts. The showroom within the house had large varieties of wooden items including plates, bowls, dishes, key rings, women's ornaments etc. all made of timber wood. The quality of items spoke of good craftsmanship. The owner's son Kajal Ho of Chakasang clan of Naga community who showed us around was a student studying BA with Hans in economics in a local college. We had also visited museum and park under Northeast Cultural Center. On our way to crafts village we had visited a nursing school close to Dimapur city. Dimapur roads were in deplorable state. Due to continued jolts and jerks suffered during the day-long local trip in a hired car, I fell sick, and we had to cancel our next day's program. The introduction for Kohima part of visit will follow at the appropriate segment of the video.
এড়িয়ে তারে পালাশনারে ভরা দিতে কাতর দীর্ঘ পথে ছুটে ছুটে দীর্ঘ করিস দুঃখটা তোর মরতে মরতে মরণ তারে শেষ করে দে একেবারে মরতে মরতে মরণ তারে শেষ করে দে একেবারে তারপরে সেই জীবন এসে আপন আসন আপনি লবে দুঃখ যদি না পাবে তো দুঃখ তোমার ঘুচবে কবে বিষকে বিষে দাহ দিয়ে দহন করে মারতে হবে দুঃখ যদি না পাবে তো দুঃখ তোমার
Here I continue with my introduction for Kohima part of my visit to Nagaland. From Dimapur we went to Guwahati after visiting Haphlong and Mabon for 2 days. From Guwahati my friend Asu returned to Kolkata. I returned to Dimapur on the January 25th and spending the night there started for Kohima next morning by a local taxi. For visiting Kohima or other hill districts of Nagaland Indians require to take an inner line permit for specific destination. I had procured it for Kohima from Kolkata office of Nagaland government and it was valid for January 25, 2018 to January 31, 2018. Anyway, I reached Kohima at around 12:30 p.m. I put up in a hotel named Pine Hotel near Oking Hospital. From my hotel room I could have the view of hills with tiny houses scattered along its ridges, at times covered with fog or mist. The road between Dimapur and Kohima was bad in stretches. Different stages of expansion work were in progress at many of the places. I found hills being destroyed for expansion of the road. On the day of my arrival in Kohima I roamed around places near my hotel and along the road to main town for some distance, taking photographs here and there. Next day was my day for visiting places of interest. I got up early and checked the temperature which was 1 degree Celsius. It rose to 7 degree at around 8 a.m. I had a hot bath and felt comfortable. I hired a taxi and started for visiting places of tourist attraction. First, I went to Kohima Catholic Church, Mary Help of Christians Church. It's an architectural marvel besides being the center of Catholic Church of Nagaland. The semi-circular building with its modern architectural thinking covers one side of the armature hill. Its facade is shaped in line with the traditional Naga house. The magnificent crucifix is carved in wood. The figure has 16 feet height, possibly one of the tallest wooden carved crucifixes in Asia. The semi-circular gallery has a sitting capacity for 3,000 and standing capacity for another 1,500. The campus provides for Naga cultural presentation. The building, painting, the furniture, etc. are modeled after the Naga tradition and heritage. In keeping up the Naga tradition, the campus is marked with 4 gates in 4 directions, north, south, west, and east. Construction work of this church began in 1986 and dedication and consecration made in 1991. Source, Internet. From the cathedral I went to Naga Heritage Village after traveling through considerable length of hilly road. Naga Heritage Village, also known as Kisama Heritage Village, is only one in Nagaland. The place is situated at the foothills of the lustrous and evergreen hills on the borderline of this village. Its rich heritage speaks volumes about its cultures and customs. There are unique thatched roofs on the traditionally built houses, its wooden walls and delicately and neatly done carvings of different designs, all of it has an age-old rural essence. This village comprises of morungs or 16 different houses that are designed and made in such a way that it symbolizes 16 communities of the population residing here. After visiting Heritage Village, I went to Kohima War Cemetery again after traveling considerable distance through hilly roads. Kohima War Cemetery is a memorial dedicated to soldiers of the 2nd British Division of the Allied Forces who died in the Second World War at Kohima, the capital of Nagaland, in April 1944. The soldiers died on the battleground of Garrison Hill in the tennis court area of the Deputy Commissioner's residence. According to the Commonwealth War Graves Commission, which maintains the cemetery among many others in the world, there are 1,420 Commonwealth burials of the Second World War at this cemetery, and a memorial to an additional 917 Hindu and Sikh soldiers who were cremated in accordance with their faith. The cemetery is set in peaceful surroundings with well-manicured grassland in which roses bloom in season. The cemetery is sited at the exact location where the battle was fought and provides a panoramic view of the town of Kohima. It is marked at its two ends by tall, concrete structures engraved with the cross. Between the two structures, along the sloping ground, a series of terraces of 3 to 5 meters, 9.8 to 16.4 feet, in height have been created. These contain stone markers embedded with bronze plaques carrying the name of each Commonwealth soldier who died on the Kohima battlefield. There are two memorial crosses, one at the upper end and the other at the lower end of the cemetery. The upper end memorial is located at the highest end of the cemetery. It commemorates the names of the 917 Indian and Sikh soldiers who were part of the British Indian Army and died on the battlefield. The epitaph inscribed on this memorial reads, quote, "Here, around the tennis court of the Deputy Commissioner, lie men who fought in the Battle of Kohima in which they and their comrades finally halted the invasion of India by the forces of Japan in April 1944, unquote. The lower end memorial is dedicated to the 2nd Division. It is 15 feet, 4.6 m, tall, massive stone, similar to the stone used by the Naga tribes to mark the graves of their dead, fixed over a dressed stone platform. This stone was originally located on a spur at Maram, to the south of Kohima, which was then shifted with the help of Naga people to be erected at the 2nd British Division's War Cemetery. While the top part of the memorial is marked with a cross, at the lower part lies a bronze plate that carries an epitaph. The epitaph, titled Kohima Epitaph, reads, quote, "When you go home tell them of us and say for your tomorrow we gave our today," unquote. Source: Wikipedia. After visiting War Cemetery, I traveled through the main Kohima town and visited Nagaland Secretariat located in wonderful natural surroundings. The architectural design of the Secretariat complex was eye-catching. My sightseeing trip ended with my return from here back to the hotel. After a night's rest I left Kohima next day the 28th of January 2018 in the morning with my heart filled with what I saw. Ironically, the inner line permit I had carried for visiting Kohima was not checked anywhere during my trip. In conclusion, I must add here to benefit of those listening or planning to visit Kohima that the best time to visit is the first week of December when Naga National Festival, Hornbill takes place. Narration ends here. But the video will continue leading up to Kohima and then showing places of attraction with accompaniment of musical clips. Hope you will enjoy. Danyabad. Scripted by Ajoy Kumar Das. Narrated by Computer Voice Engine.
তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে তবে একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো রে তবে একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে ¶¶ যদি কেউ কথা না কয় ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা কেউ কথা না কয় যদি সবাই থাকে মুখ ফিরায়ে সবাই করে ভয় যদি সবাই থাকে মুখ ফিরায়ে সবাই করে ভয় তবে পরাণ খুলে ও তুই মুখ ফুটে তোর মনের কথা একলা বলো রে ও তুই মুখ ফুটে তোর মনের কথা একলা বলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি সবাই ফিরে যায় ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা সবাই ফিরে যায় যদি গহন পথে যাবার কালে কেউ ফিরে না চায় যদি গহন পথে যাবার কালে কেউ ফিরে না চায় তবে পথের কাঁটা ও তুই রক্ত মাখা চরণ তলে একলা দল রে ও তুই রক্ত মাখা চরণ তলে একলা দল রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি আলো না ধরে ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা আলো না ধরে যদি ঝড় বাদলে আধার রাতে দুয়ার দেয় ঘরে যদি ঝড় বাদলে আধার রাতে দুয়ার দেয় ঘরে তবে বজ্রানলে আপন বুকের পাঁজর জ্বালিয়ে নিয়ে একলা জল রে আপন বুকের পাঁজর জ্বালিয়ে নিয়ে একলা জল রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह एक रोशनी बिखरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की हादसा वो पहली मुलाकात क्या कहूँ, कितनी अजब थी सूरत हालात क्या कहूँ, वो कहर वो गजब वो जफा मुझको याद है, वो उसकी बेरुखी की अदा मुझको याद है, मिटता नहीं ज़हन से यूं छा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह पहले वो मुझको देख कर बरहम सी हो गई, पहले वो मुझको देख कर बरहम सी हो गई, फिर अपने ही हसीन ख्यालों में खो गई, बेचारगी पे मेरी उसे रहम आ गया, शायद मेरे तड़पने का अंदाज भाग गया, सांसों से भी करीब मेरे आ गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह उस दिले तबाह की हालत न पूछिए, अब उस दिले तबाह की हालत न पूछिए, बेनाम आरज़ूओं की लज़्ज़त न पूछिए, कि अजनबी था रूह का अरमान बन गया, एक हादसा था प्यार का उन्वान बन गया, मंजिल का रास्ता मुझे दिखला गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह एक रोशनी बिखरा गया कोई, जिंदगी की राह टकरा गया कोई।
मरण रे तू मेघवरण तुझ मेघ जटा जुट रक्त कमल कर रक्त अधर पुट ताप विमोचन करुण कोर तब मृत्यु अमृत कर दान तुहु मम राधा हृदय तू कब আবাদে মেরা মাগানা ভাবা তাড়িতা চাকিতা আতি ঘোরা মে ঘরাবা গগন সাঘন আবাদে মেরা মাগানা ভাবা তাড়িতা চাকিতা আতি ঘোরা মে ঘরাবা শাল দেখো Shine.